Paul Schmoller, being posthumously inducted into the National Lacrosse Hall of Fame as a truly great player by his college teammates Joe Lizzio, Michael DiStefano, and Hall of Fame member Tim Goldstein.
Paul Schmoller was just amazing news. He came on the team as a freshman, I was a sophomore, and started right away in goal, and he just took charge right away. I mean, he marks out orders to us, he can tell us where to be on the field, and somehow he's playing the goal. He knew where all of the six guys should be, and it would be Mike Pitier. It was just amazing how he took charge from day one. All these individuals, I was saying, just so quick with hands, quick with feet. It just seemed, I think the ball seemed like it was slow to him. Very relaxed guy, easy to get along with. Really missed him a lot. He was such a mellow, laid-back guy, easy to get along with. And then really, one thing that epitomized him on that trip is how chill he is. He's so relaxed. And when you get him in a lacrosse game, you know, where you're tied and going into overtime, he is just even keel. Never gets high, never gets low, and just nothing bothers that guy. Paul was just such a unique talent. It was once he got out there, just like, wow, it's at a different level. It was pretty evident after a lot of practices that Paul was going to eventually win the starting job. Paul had something special in practice, and he was competitive, and he was always on. And he was so competitive, even at the end of a long practice. Paul always just followed his heart. He loved cooking. He loved lacrosse, he loved teaching, he did it passionately, he never had any regrets. I think it's a great way to live life. And we still wish he was in Cave with us, we'd win more Masters games. Paul was just the guy who just loved lacrosse, and that was, came across the first time I met him. It was obvious that was the passion. I think that the ability to go against Paul every day in practice, and other two goals were phenomenal as well, made us better players. What I remember about Paul's role that really stood out is anytime he played club ball, Team USA, obviously college, the other team always knew that they were against Paul was going to be a tough day. And that's really what made him special. 1990 was the time that I played on Team USA with Paul, which was special for both of us, not only because going such a far away, it's an honor to play for Team USA. Paul was one of three unbelievable goalies, Sal and Larry Quinn. And again, that was a way of just going against the best every day and made us even better. Knowing that he made it to Team USA was special to him. It was obvious. And he was proud of it. And you could always see those where bring his Team USA lacrosse bag to every club tournament that we did in the future. So it was just a special accomplishment for Paul. I know he made it the second time, and again, another feather in the cap, which just shows how beautiful he was and just his pure passion for the sport was evident. Happiness to be part of the team. Everybody knows that a good goalie, a great goalie can make a difference. And Paul was that great goalie. He's going into the whole thing because he deserves it. When he knew he was dying, he was kind of expressing, you know, kind of remembering it all. Because I think he was something he really wanted.
We miss him a lot, we love him, and we're really happy, you know, that we're behind him this way, and his family.
Congratulations also to the individuals who are joining him, and all the past inductees, and to their families. Thank you, friends, Paul's past teammates, high school, club, Cornell USA team, players who were coached by Paul, coaches who coached with Paul, his coach, Richie Moran, our families, and the many people who advocated for this award. I'm grateful for all the miles we've traveled. For several weeks, we've enjoyed the anticipation of this night. I'm hoping you all have the fullness of my happy heart to reach this moment, and that I'm certain Paul lives with this honor, since we all surely know he's in heaven. Some of you may recall Paul's induction speech at the Long Island Metropolitan Hall of Fame. He was so deeply moved by his award and said the only thing missing was his greatest fan, his mother, Bea, who never missed a single game. Paul, the master of the pregnant pause, was so overcome by emotion he stood weeping and silent for a good 5 minutes. The audience was silent and weeping too. Finally, a few hearty shouts of "We love you, Paulie" broke his trance and he rallied. That's how loved Paul was and is tonight, once again. Cheers to Doc, Lou Schmoller, and B. Schmoller, Paul's parents, who raised him with their extraordinary parenting skills in an anything but ordinary household. If you think a 12-year-old boy riding his bike down Cedar Swamp Road in Long Island to play wall ball at CW Post College with a raccoon on his shoulder is ordinary, please see me at the reception. In addition to the Schmoller family letting all creatures be small during a high school game, Paul's helmet was hit so fiercely that the tip of his nose came loose. Doc applied duct tape and Paul was in the game. From what I understand, he never forgave Doc for patching up like a dog instead of taking him directly to the surgeon. For years after, Paul's nails lit up like Rudolph in cold weather. Bea and Doc Schmoller were active, respected, revered, and positive influences in their community. They raised Paul and all their children so well. I'd love it if Steve, Lauren, and Alan, his siblings, would stand up. Compels me to keep learning, giving, and loving. news of Paul's induction has truly made our year. On behalf of his family and Paul, we're also grateful for his honor. It's with so much love that I accept on his behalf the induction of Paul Scholar into the U.S. Hall of Fame. Thank you.
Lynn Ellen, please know that the lacrosse community stands with you and the Schmoller family.